गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे लेट्स डिस्कस द क्वेश्चन आंसर्स ऑफ गुड फ्रेंड्स विदाउट नीड। वुड यू लाइक टू बिकम इनविजिबल एंड व्हाट एडवांटेजेस एंड डिसएडवांटेजेस डू यू फोरसी? सो इफ यू डिड, व्हाट इज फोरसी? व्हाट इज मीनिंग ऑफ फोरसी? 4C means to think about something in advance. Okay, what is 4C? When you are able to think before, in advance, when you are able to make out like what would be the consequences or benefits or disadvantages of something. Point is, like, would you like to become invisible? Before you say yes or no, what advantages and disadvantages do you foresee if you did? Imagine you became invisible, then what do you think would be the advantages and disadvantages? So first of all, you have to answer, like, would you like to become invisible? Okay, you can say anything, your wish. Suppose you say, like, yes, you would like to become invisible. Yes, surely I would like to become invisible. Maybe not forever, but yes. It should be under my control that whenever I want to become invisible, then I would become invisible. And when I want to become visible, then it would be so. So the things should be under my control. Then yes. Otherwise, definitely not at all. Yes. If I become invisible, then I think there would be a lot of things which will go in my favor. So then you tell what advantages you foresee. Now you speak. Okay, but here let me challenge you. You can go otherwise also to any mall or store, isn't it? Nobody stops you. Yeah, money. Okay, you want to go to those places without money? You want to do stealing? So you want to steal if you want to become invisible. Is that okay?
No.
Then what's the use of becoming invisible? Yeah. Okay, so that was not okay. Because even if you try to go as an invisible person to some place, you will have your body, your footprints and all. So you'll be caught later on. Forensic department will not leave you. Right? And nowadays, Aadhaar and all that enables the forensic department to spot you from anywhere, wherever you go, because everybody's these fingerprints are unique. Do you know this?
Yeah.
You can be easily identified. So at the time when this Griffin was there, then Aadhaar system was not there, but now it is there. Okay. Now no one can be unidentified. Okay. Yes. Later on, the law authorities, how active they are in spotting the criminals, that is a different issue. But one can be easily identified nowadays on the basis of one's fingerprints. Okay, everybody's fingerprints are unique. And Aadhaar has made everybody's fingerprints there. Okay, it is in the government's records. And somebody who doesn't have the Aadhaar, I guess, that person cannot sustain his life in the country like India now. For every place, wherever you go, you have to give your Aadhaar number and Aadhaar card. Okay, even you people have submitted your Aadhaar numbers, isn't it? When you go, if you have to get yourself vaccinated, then also your Aadhaar card will be required. Wherever, whatever. Okay, Aadhaar is your identity now. You cannot get anything done without Aadhaar. Right? So the point is, like, if you become invisible, then yes, Lokesh. Okay, you can help the defense system. Can you explain a little bit, like, how can you do this?
When it's a terrorist attack, they are planning to attack on some areas that we can get the information that they are using for their past attack. That's the most common that they are
many a times we sent our spies for defense purpose, and we put their lives at risk. When I would have the chance to become invisible, then of course I would help my defense, my army, in spotting the terrorists or the criminal activities going somewhere in my country. So being invisible, I'll be serving my country. So then nobody will be after your footprints and all, because you will be in the army. Okay, and then there are spies in the army. Yes, and their work is to do something which the invisible man can do easily. Okay, so what could be the disadvantages? Advantages, we were talking like you can serve your country, right? What else? What disadvantages do you think there are as an invisible man? But when we think, yeah, if we have the same conditions the way Griffin had, then of course that is there. If you think, you can imagine that there are conditions in which you can become invisible, thereby having clothes on and all. You just take one medicine and you become invisible. Yeah, clothes will also become invisible. Or you have a spray, something like that, that you become invisible. Then there might be some advantages, some disadvantages. So what would be the disadvantages? But even if you become invisible, I'll be able to make out like it's Dhamnesh. Then, okay. Yeah, you will feel lonely, yes. So, what's the biggest drawback of being invisible? You'll be lonely. And this Griffin, you will see, you read the novel. He will feel lonely in the end. He will get alienated. No one will be with him. So you struck the very right chord. Okay, actually it happens. So whatever is natural, that is best. Okay, if we go in for something unnatural, then the results are usually disastrous. So it's okay in the end that I would be happy being visible. Right? But yes, you can imagine whatever the drawbacks. That is up to you. Are there forces around us that are invisible, for example? Are there forces around us that are invisible? For example, magnetism, gravity. So are there aspects of matter that are invisible or not? Or not visible to the naked eye? What would the world be like if you could see such forces or such aspects of matter? So yes, there are so many things, so many forces which are invisible. So force of gravity, the magnetism and all, right? So there are so many things which are invisible. So the point is, like, what would the world be like if you could see such things? What could be the life be like then? Imagine if you were able to see gravity, gravitational forces happening around. Imagine if you could see air moving about. Imagine you could see oxygen going in, carbon dioxide coming out. What would have been the form of the life then? Interesting or very, very stressed? Huh? Your imagination would? Yes. Your imagination. Otherwise, we have such a clear view of the world. Isn't it? I can see you people so clearly. Had there been the layers of oxygen, carbon dioxide, gravity, magnetism, then what would be the case? The whole place would become so cluttered up, isn't it? And I don't know how you people would look like in that layer of oxygen, carbon dioxide, nitrogen and all. The kind of place it would be a hell. So the beauty would disappear, I guess. No beauty would have been there. The world would have become quite cluttered up with all sorts of, you know, things visible. Right? So what God did, that was, so God did something most wonderfully beautiful. So I don't think if any variation is there, the world would become horrible only. And the proof is that, and it is said that when forests preceded mankind, and deserts will follow the mankind. Understand? What does it mean? Before the human being came on this earth, there was greenery and greenery and greenery. Human being came, and when the human being will go, there will be only deserts. So what does it mean? That God made this earth basically very beautiful. And it's only human beings who are making it ugly day by day. And eventually, if the doomsday will come one day, what is doomsday? When no one will survive, when the whole earth will, when all humanity will die. When the doomsday will come, that will be just because of humanity, our actions. Whatever the problems today are there, environmental problems, that they are man's gift. God gifted us beauty and man gifted this earth ugliness, problems. So the point over here is like, if there is any alteration done to this earth by us, then this earth would become all cluttered up and it would become an ugly place to live, where we won't be able to have any beautiful and clear view of each other even. You can imagine something else also if you want. Okay. Would you be able to eat curd if the things are visible? If that bacteria is visible, will you be able to enjoy the curd? You won't. So there are so many things like that. Okay. And if that, if we are able to see even the microscopic elements all around us, I guess we would not be able to drink even water. Because all those microscopic bacteria are almost everywhere. Okay, with the advent of corona, we have started sanitizing and all. But otherwise also, we need to keep our hands always clean. Isn't it? You know, before food and all, it's our culture that we should keep our hands clean daily, always. But corona taught us, made us revise the things, which the humanity had forgotten basically. So what makes glass or water transparent? What makes glass or water transparent? What's the scientific explanation for this? Yes, you tell. Why is water transparent? Yes, Chayank. Come here.
Ma'am, whenever the things become transparent, it means that they are not allowing the light rays to reflect in our eyes. Anything become transparent only when it does not reflect the light rays in our eyes. If that glass on the door is transparent only because it allows light rays to pass through but not reflect back, this glass can reflect the light rays coming from the tube light to our eyes. That's why we can see.
Very well done, Chayank. Give him a big hand. Silent. So yes. The point is, like, do you think it would be scientifically possible for a man to become invisible or transparent? Scientifically, is it possible for a human being to become invisible? No. because human body is opaque. Keep in mind that writers of science fiction have often turned out to be prophetic in their imagination. Okay, prophetic is they have got a sagacious wisdom. Okay, prophet, saint. So they can, for them, magics can happen. Magical things are very common for the writers. What kind of story is this Invisible Man? It's a science fiction. Okay, H.G. Wells is the father of science fiction. He's a pioneer in this kind of scientific stories. Okay, scientific based fiction. It's a fiction because it's not real. And it cannot happen. Human being cannot become invisible. Right? So if there is the invention of such kind of drug or spray which makes a human body become transparent, then only something like that is possible. Otherwise, scientifically, it's not possible. But what we can imagine, science does that. Isn't it? For science, nothing is impossible. What we can imagine today, maybe within 100 of years, that thing might be possible. Somebody dreamt of flying in the sky like birds and it happened. Right? So The Invisible Man by H.G. Wells, you read. Okay, suggested reading. So As Far as a Human Eye Can See by Isaac Asimov. Yes, Isaac Asimov is also one of the prolific writers as science fiction. Okay, so read this person also. It Happened Tomorrow. So this also you can read. So there are so many books to read. You can make a list of the books you can read, and one after the other, you keep on and on. Okay, your books, your bedtime books should never finish. The list should never finish. One after the other, keep on. Yes. Okay.